Hello. I agree, Calissa, that you are doing wonders in the background with the financial stuff. So if that's your contribution, I think that's great. I think what Ashley was saying and what I agree with Ashley is that if you could find something you don't mind committing to, even if it's just once a month, not that you have to commit, and I'm not saying you have to, but if you could find something that tells mom that you love her. I'm trying to think of the right word, and that was the only one I can think of. Like, I'm sure mom knows you love her, but maybe she doesn't know that you love her. I don't know. Ashley, help me out here. Am I not saying this correctly? How do you say it? Calissa, you know that things are awkward between you and mom, and mom knows they're awkward between you and mom, and I know you don't really want them to be better. You don't want a relationship necessarily with mom. So any socializing that you do with mom, you're probably feeling like you're faking it, which is not speaking your truth, which that's why I hesitate asking you to do anything. I don't know. I guess I would just like to see you guys have some sort of relationship, even if it's just acquaintances, where you look forward to talking to your acquaintance at happy hour. Okay, I'll see you next week on happy hour, or next month at happy hour. And just learn to appreciate her as an acquaintance, I guess, not necessarily as a mother, if that's too hard right now. I don't know. I'm not you. I'm not you. I can't tell you what you want to do or what you should do. And that's not, it's not my place. I'm just throwing an idea out there. Anyway. Oh, the last thing I was going to say was, the one about your own happiness jar. Basically, I made an absolute, you know, an absolute is like always or never absolutes. I made an absolute and I said, Mom is scared to feel anything but happy. So much so that when she was sad or mad or frustrated or overwhelmed or anxious or feeling insignificant, whatever her feelings were, if she was not happy as a married woman to Dad or to Van Deer or to Dave, Ramon, Keith, it didn't matter. She took off. She ran away. Oh, hi, Ash. I just saw that you were on. Mom ran away from difficult situations. From confronting herself. She didn't want to confront herself. She didn't want to own her stuff as her problem. She victimized herself and said, because you're not doing it right, I'm not happy. Because you're not treating me better, I'm not happy. Because you, I'm not happy. And by that kind of mentality, she said, well, okay. You did this to me, so I'm gonna leave you. And then she left him. But everywhere she went, she took herself with her, right? So when it came to Keith, if she didn't have a road trip coming up, if she didn't have something to look forward to and escape to and do her own thing, that was bittersweet, I think. She liked coming home. She liked being a mom and being a wife and paying the bills and turning on her music and just being at the house. But when the road called, she loved doing that too. You know, she loves She loves being spontaneous and she loves doing her own thing and she loves the freedom and she loves just popping in and out and just doing her own thing. because that's what makes her happy. She doesn't really want to sit still long enough to have anything come up for her. And if something comes up for her, she tries to meditate it away and tries to be happy and tries to push herself to be happy and think happy thoughts. And it's not bad to do that when you're trying to move away from those dark feelings or whatever. But it got to be to the point where I don't think there was a long stretch of time, right when the drives weren't there anymore, and she had to get a regular job and she had to work and that. Now she's boxed, now she's in a cage, now she's not happy, and drinking was her escape. Drinking was her way of not caring about how hard it was or whatever. So that's what I'm saying is, yes, she created her own happiness. Yes, that's definitely true. She knows how to do that. But happiness is not everything. Sometimes when you're confronted with all that pain and all that anger and all that frustration and all that I'm not good enough and all that unworthiness and all that I'm lonely and all that everything, when you're confronted with that, what do you do to get through it? How do you sit with it? How do you process it? I'm not talking about how do you get happy again. I'm talking about how do you own it? How do you dive into it? How do you discover what that's all about? How do you become friends with it? That's the best thing. You gotta become friends with it. If you're not friends with your deepest, darkest anger and pain in the pit of your stomach and allow yourself to feel that, then you're always going to be escaping and fleeing and wandering and thinking that I can't feel this, can't feel that, you know. And I think that's her conditioning as a child, as, you know, as a Howard. They weren't allowed to have complaints. They weren't allowed to speak up. They weren't allowed to talk back. They weren't allowed to be upset, to cry, to whine, to complain. I mean, if they had a problem, they had to suck it up and just pretend like everything's fine. I mean, the image of happy was like their identity. If they didn't have that happy identity, if Mary Sunshine wasn't Mary Sunshine, oh my gosh. Mary got the bully end of the stick. She got, you know, criticized, or you're being too sensitive, you're being too dramatic, you're being too, and she was shamed for being anything but happy. So she forced herself to be happy, and to this day, that is what's creating her, I think that's what's creating her addiction, is that she doesn't know what to do with herself when she's not happy. And that's an absolute, because of course I don't know in every situation if that's true. I did say something to her today. She said that when she had stopped drinking, she was with Christopher, living at his house. And when she had stopped drinking and she was meditating a lot and she was doing really well, she needed something to get herself happy. That was the word she used tonight. And she bought herself a disco ball with the lights and everything. And her and the kids would dance and dance and dance. And she says, and that really just kept me in a good mood, and it kept me happy, and it kept me from falling off the wagon again. And I'm like thinking to myself, this is exactly what I was talking to Ashley and Calissa about. I'm listening to Mom explain it to me again. And I'm like, see, even though I'm saying it as an absolute, I think it's an absolute in Mom's head. I think it's an absolute in Mom's head that she's not allowed to feel anything but happy. Did you ever see the movie Pursuit of Happiness with Will Smith? Pursuit of Happiness. It's a very fascinating movie. If you haven't seen it, I highly recommend it. It's quite old, I'm sure, but Pursuit of Happiness, they said a line, a quote in there that really relates. And the American Constitution, it's an American's right to search for the pursuit of happiness. The pursuit of happiness is every American's right. The pursuit of happiness is the American right. Nobody promised any American that they would be happy. But it is the right of the American to pursue it. The pursuit of happiness is an American right. It's an American dream. Pursuit, that means we're always going to chase it. It's never something that's obtained. It's never something that we can actually have and hold on to for long periods of time. We're not meant to. Nobody is meant to be happy 100% of the time. And if that's mom's mentality, she is always going to fall. She is always going to plummet into her depths of despair. And that's what I said to her after she told me that disco ball thing. I said, Mom, I have something to challenge you with. And she's like, what's that? And I go, I don't want you to say anything. I just want you to sit with it. I don't want you to get defensive and tell me whatever you're going to tell me. Just sit with it for a second. I'm going to challenge you with a thought. And she's like, okay, what's that? And I said, instead of finding something that'll make you happy to prevent you from drinking again, try to figure out what you can do to allow yourself to feel the feelings that are coming up for you instead of forcing yourself to be happy. She's like, well, I already do that. And then she goes into defense and I go, all right, Mom, I'm gonna let you go. I love you. Bye. Like, I really hurry and got off the phone with her like rather quickly because we had dinner going on anyway. But I'm just like, she won't listen. She won't own her stuff. She thinks that she's listening to sad songs and you know, feeling the feels. And maybe she is. And that's why I'm questioning my absolute. That's why I questioned you guys earlier today. Do you think I'm right? Does she always chase happiness? Does she ever know what to do when these feelings come up for her? Because I think she thinks she does. Okay? I think she thinks that she has these feelings come up and then she meditates and then she feels better. Mom? Can you meditate and not feel better? Oh, meditation always makes me feel better, always puts me in a good mood. Okay, what if the good mood's not the goal? What if you can just let the good mood stay over there for a second? What if the goal is just to sit with the bad mood, sit with the feelings of sadness, sit with the feelings of loneliness, sit with the feelings of not good enough, discover what that's all about, dig deep. What is that all about? I know you know. You know you've talked about it. You've talked about your family. You've talked about your parents. You've talked about your husbands. And you've talked about all the things that don't make you happy. But instead of blaming, and saying they, dig even deeper than that and then own it. Am I making any sense? Like, am I making any sense that it doesn't have to be anybody's fault? Once you can let go of the blame and you can get down to the deep, dark level of owning it, it's almost like it doesn't matter what anybody did to you. You rised above it and you pursued and whatever. And when she can sit with it long enough and not let the despair get to her. And trust me, I know it's hard. I get despaired and I get it. At some point, you gotta just say, I'm not happy right now, and I'm just going to sit with it. I'm not happy right now, and I'm just going to be here for a minute. Anyways, Ashley has signed off, so that tells me I've spoken too long. It's like she's probably going to bed, or no. I thought you stayed up late. I think that's what your schedule is. You stay up until 8? I don't know anymore. I'm so confused. But anyway, yeah, let me know when happy hour is. And I think it would be funny to call it happy hour. It's probably not appropriate for an alcoholic, but I think it would be funny. My happy daughter hour. Anyways, okay, talk to you later. Bye.